What's up, interwebs? My name is Cravol, and I have made a mistake. Oh my goodness. That's not my intro. Let's try that again. What's up, interwebs? My name is Cravol, and welcome back to Depression. What's up, interwebs? My name is Cravol, and welcome back to the channel. I need to, make a quick apology. So, at this point, almost 2 months ago, I announced a Q&A for 1,000 subscribers, and I was gonna get really close, and, you know, I had uploaded it along with a video series that usually gets my channel, you know, quite a bit of views, and, it didn't work. We're still not quite at 1,000 subscribers. Now, I have no doubt that I'm gonna hit it sometime this year, but now I'm kind of in this awkward position that I have comments asking questions, and I want to answer them, but we're still not technically at 1,000 subscribers. So I'm going to go ahead and answer those comments, but just know that this is kind of an early celebration. I still think we're going to be hitting 1,000 subscribers soon, and I'll kind of talk about the future of the channel in a bit here, but for now, I just want to give back and give you guys the answers to those questions that you've been waiting about 2 months for now. So let's get into that. First question comes from Sal, who asks, what's your opinion? What decks are better in the current meta, controller aggro? And this was asked much closer to when Witchwood was released. The thing is, I don't know if either is necessarily stronger, and I'll kind of explain my answer fully here. So what I see in the current meta, even after the patch, which I haven't played a ton of comp after the patch, but still what I'm seeing is that, you know, kind of control is fast enough to be aggro out. Each of their cards is worth several cards from the aggro deck. Aggro is able to rush down a lot of combo decks, and combo is able to build up damage and get past any control's defense. So the problem comes from, you know, decks like Q-Block that are able to kind of do multiple things, because Q-Block, if they summon a bunch of, you know, Void Lords, it's a lot more control-based, and they can kind of get those out early and just stop aggro from ever attacking their face, whereas they can also summon a bunch of Doom Guards, and then you kind of have a more combo-based deck on your hands. But again, I haven't played in a while. I'm not a great Hearthstone player, honestly, which I'll have you keep in mind for all of this video, but that's kind of what I see there, and that would be my opinion on it. So, next question is, what is your favorite Hearthstone card and class in the game's history? Now, my favorite class, this is an easy one, is Warlock. Warlock all the way. I love the aesthetic of, you know, you kind of have more than just your mana to consider. You're considering your health, you're considering if you can discard any cards, stuff like that. And I think that class is just a blast. It's a lot of fun, really. My favorite Hearthstone card is a much more tricky one. Honestly, I've absolutely fallen in love with both Gen and Baku. I feel like they are kind of a fully realized version of, you know, this as early as Reno Jackson deck building challenge, where you have to build your deck a certain way to use a card. And they work in a way that you both do that, but you also gain a bonus from it the entire game. So I love that, but more than that, I absolutely fell in love with the Hunter Quest. I don't know why, but just something about that quest makes me very happy and giddy inside, and it might come from the fact that I absolutely loved dinosaurs as a kid. I don't know, but I crafted myself a golden Hunter Quest after the expansion came out, and yeah, I would still have to say that I've had a lot of fun with that card, and that's probably one of my all-time favorite Hearthstone cards. So, coming from Temmie Animations, who, first of all, Temmie, I would not stand this if it wasn't from you. You have been so loyal to the channel, so thank you for that. But also, was not plus 10. 21. Is that what you... Is this what you wanted, Temmie? Yeah? Okay. Thanks. Thanks for playing along. Next, we have Why No Ketchup Cream. This one needs a bit of explaining. So for those of you who haven't seen my April 1st video or the follow-up video, in my April 1st video, it's a really dumb video in which I kind of pretend to be a review channel and I review great value foods. And then one of my friends loved it so much that they sent me more great value foods to review. Now their intent was they sent these kind of cheesy chips and they wanted me to dip them in ketchup. The thing is, those chips basically tasted like stale Doritos, and I don't want to taste stale Dorito and overly sweet ketchup, I'm sorry. If that's a thing that a lot of people want, I might consider it in a future video, but really probably never. And finally, what do you think will change since Ben Brode left Hearthstone, and what are your opinions on this? So from a personal standpoint, me as just a fan of the game, someone who loves the game a lot, I teared up, man, honestly. Ben Brode has been such a huge part of what has made Hearthstone Hearthstone, honestly. The guy just has this aura of, you know, fun and just clearly loved the game so much. But from a professional standpoint, I don't know if it's gonna change a lot of stuff. I didn't really know a ton about him until after I had very much gotten into the game, and I have a lot of friends that play the game casually, you know, just kind of get back into it every couple expansions, that again, really don't know a ton about him, and don't really pay a ton of attention to the advertising. So I think between, you know, advertising, I don't think it's gonna be that big of an impact, and I don't think, I think that the team working on the game has a clear enough vision of what the game's supposed to look like that, again, it's not going to noticeably affect any of the final product. In my personal opinion, we'll just have to wait and see, I guess. Alright guys, so that's all of the questions that I got. Hopefully the people that asked those got to see this video. At this point, I just want to kind of talk a little bit about the future of the channel, where stuff is headed, and yes. I really liked making this video, honestly, even if it wasn't quite on the terms that I set out for, and I just like interacting with you guys a bit, and I do have plans for more of that. What I am going to say is that you guys should really join the Discord server. That'll make it easier for me to get in contact with you guys, even if it's not super busy right now. You know, because then instead of posting a video like this and publicly embarrassing myself, I can just quietly do an add everyone and go, hey, if anyone has anything to add to this, it might show up in a video, blah, 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 blah. So really, honestly, if you are interested in doing further interactions with me, and I'm talking custom Hearthstone cards, potentially taking part in games just as a group, I think that was definitely something I'm going to be planning to do, and, you know, even honest Hearthstone cards, I might be asking for you guys' input on one of the future ones. I have a really good idea for one that I want to do down the line. You guys should really join the Discord channel if you want to take part in some of that stuff, and just be present. I'll leave a link in the description for you guys to join. And other than that, after this video, we're going back to pretty much the big schedule for the next month here or so. I should have a little bit more time, so maybe an extra upload here or there. I think starting next week with just some good old Hearthstone gameplay. I've been messing around with a fun deck idea, and it's working pretty well, so we'll see how that goes. Alright, with all of that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm sorry for, again, low effort content. Hopefully I have something better for you guys next week. Yeah, hope you guys all have a great rest of your day.